Yo, what's up YouTube? It's your boy Emperor Mufasa back with another NBA 2K18 video. Now, in today's video, I'll be showing you guys how to get that ankle breaker badge extremely quick. Now, in this year's 2K NBA 2K18, the ankle breaker badge is actually one of the easier badges to get this year in NBA 2K18. Now, I'm going to be showing you guys the things that you should be doing more in order to get this badge faster and the things that you should be doing less, the things that are wasting your time. So now let's just jump around how to do this. Now, the first thing, of course, go to your My Career. Now, look at my screen right here. The first thing I'm going to do is call for the ball. Of course, once you do get the ball, you want to call for an ISO by hitting left on the D-pad and then hitting down on that right bumper. Now, once that does happen, you're gonna get an ISO. Now, this is where you start doing your dribble moves. All you want to do is just do a bunch of dribble moves, not that much where you get so tired, just as much as you see me doing right here on my mic court. The next thing you're gonna want to do is call for a screen. Once the screen is where I am at right now, hit a rhythm dribble by flicking your right analog stick up and then just simply run to the way you can speed boost. And that's a very easy way to get to the basket this year in NBA 2K18. As you guys can see right there, that pick freed me up extremely easy. And the way to get this badge fast is that you just do some moves and then you just drive to the basket and just make that layup. That's how you get the ankle breaker badge this year. In previous 2Ks, it was either you do double move and then you score and then double move or you get an assist. This year is literally you just go in for a layup. Make sure you just do like one or two dribble moves when you're actually going out for the layup. Now, the reason I tell you guys to do it the way I am doing it is because this year in NBA 2K18, my career, you can lose the ball so easy. Even at the park, you lose the ball so easy when you're dribbling the ball. So if you call for that screen, more than likely, if you hit the rhythm dribble at the right time, and if you guys don't know what rhythm dribbles to use, don't worry, I'm gonna be dropping the best dribble moves video, I think tomorrow actually. So make sure and stay tuned for that because I have one of the best dribble moves in NBA 2K18 as of right now. But you do need to hit that rhythm dribble just because you can speed boost and get that extra burst of speed when you're driving to the basket. And it's going to be hard for the computers to stay with you, especially since your teammate is sending you that screen. Like I said, you're going to get most of the points from just dribbling the ball up the court. And then once you do get that screen, it's going to be very easy to drive to the basket. This is the most efficient and easy way. If you do not want to get a bad grade and you just don't want to just sim these games, you actually do want to play My Career, but you want to smartly grind out for these badges, or this is the fastest and quickest efficient way. If you still want to play My Career, if you still just want to have fun, but you at the same time, you want to grind for a specific badge quicker, then this is the perfect method for you guys. And like I said, if you want to get these badges even quicker, I recommend you put it on 12-minute quarters. I don't like to put on 12 minute quarters just because I like to get through the story mode. I like to just get more games in than just have one long ass game. So that's why I keep it at 6 minutes. Now, at the end of the game, of course, this is when you do get your points. Now, depending on how long you put your quarter length, this is how many points you're gonna get. So if you put it on 12 minute quarters, then of course you're gonna be getting so many more points when compared to someone like myself, where I only put it on 6 minute quarters. But in reality, look at all the points I'm still getting. My ankle breaker badge is almost to gold, and I really haven't even played that many games. So that means I'll be getting my Hall of Fame ankle breaker badge pretty damn soon, which is pretty damn crazy. And this game just was released today. Honestly, for most people, it was released today on Tuesday. But this is the main important part where people get wrong. People feel like when you go to the team practice facility, people have already told me this is where you get grind for your badges, whereas this is where you get the most points. And I went to go try it out, and to me, that is not the case. Now, just look at this right here. You can specifically grind out any badge you want. If you want to grind out for difficult shots, just go under the difficult shots section and just work on that specific badge. So for this one, I'm gonna pick the ankle breaker section, and then it's gonna give you all these drills right here. You can pick any of these drills, and they will all go towards the ankle breaker badge. Now, I've played every single one of these drills, and trust me, you do not even get close to the amount of points versus an actual full real NBA game. So I would say that this whole team facility stuff is, in my opinion, this whole team facility thing is just a waste of time. You're not getting the near amount of points you would than playing an NBA game. Now right here, I'm showing you guys how many points I got towards my ankle breaker badge. Look at this right here. Just look at it. Just see how much it went up? If you didn't, just look at this again. It didn't even go up by, it went up by like 100 points. Just look at the side. It only went up by 142 points when compared to a NBA game when it goes up by like 2,000. As you guys can see right here, look at the difference. Look how high it goes. It says it right there. Dribble drive success, 1,800 points just towards your badge. So playing an NBA game gives you 10 times to 20 times the amount of points than you would going to this team facility. So I feel, in my opinion, that don't waste your time going to the team facility. It's just going to take more time. You're just going to be wasting so much time loading up the whole team practice facility and then loading back up into the My Career games. That's just going to take a bunch of time, all that loading. So make sure, I feel, in my opinion, you just stick with the career games. You're going to get your badges just faster like that. You're in control of the offense. You get so many more points, and you can put it to as many many as long as you want to do. So that's my opinion. Has been your boy, Improved Foster, guys. Go ahead and start grinding. I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.